Hello friends, as Sidney J. Harris rightly said, the whole purpose of education is to turn mirrors into windows. Meaning, before embarking on your higher education journey, all you have is your own experience. Education opens a window to the thought leaders near and far throughout history and lets you know, understand the world in a deeper and a more complex way. By this, myself, Tushar Patel, Assistant Professor of Department of Civil Engineering from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari, would like you to welcome all in the next episode of Harbour and Airport Engineering. Today's topic will be docks and locks. So, the content for today's topic, we'll first study about the harbour docks. Then, what is a tidal basin, types of docks and locks, and lastly, the lock gates. So, my dear students, as we all know, docks are sheltered basin for berthing ships. The water in the docks are kept at nearly constant level to enable the cargo from ships to be loaded or unloaded. Hence, the docks, sometimes known as wet docks, are an enclosed and partially enclosed basins provided with locks and entrance gate to keep the water at fairly constant level. A harbor is a place that is situated on the coast where ships, boats, barges, etc. can be moved safely. So moving across to a topic known as tidal basin, these are partly enclosed areas of water which are approached by the open entrances and are subjected to fluctuations of water levels. These basins allow vessels to come in and berth or leave at all the times. They do not require expensive arrangement like lock gates and any other structures. So there are some advantages and disadvantages of tidal basins. Moving across to the advantages, vessels can come in and berth or leave at all times. Thus, there is a speedy and unrestricted arrival and departure of ships. Costly arrangements such as lock gates for the closing of the entrances are also not required. Disadvantages of tidal basins: if the range of the tide is more, the operations for loading and unloading are seriously affected. The fluctuations of water level will cause the rubbing of sides of the ship against the berths. Moving across to the types of docks. Docks can be classified into two: repair docks or wet docks. Repair docks are further classified in the four categories. They are known as dry docks, floating docks, lift docks, and marine railways. Now, wet docks. What are wet docks? When there are variations in the tidal level, an enclosed basin is provided where in a number of ships that can be berthed. This basin has an entrance which is controlled by a lock gate. The water inside the basin can be maintained independent of the outside water level fluctuations. Thus, the dock requires for berthing of ships or vessels to facilitate the loading and unloading of passengers and cargo are called as wet docks. They are also known as harbor docks. Next are the repair docks. These are required for the ships in every harbor. In a terminal port, these facilities are essential. These are used for carrying out repair, inspection, or painting works, etc. for the ships. Thus, repair docks are used for the construction, maintenance, and repairs of the ships, boats, and other watercrafts. Next, we come across to dry dock, also known as graving dock. Now, a dry dock is a chamber having walls, floor, and a gate. As you can see in this figure, we have walls, gates, and the floor of a dry dock. They are primarily provided for maintenance, repairs, and constructions of ships. At the entrance of the dock, a lock gate is provided. This gate will be closed after bringing the vessels inside the dock and then the water will be pumped out to make it dry so that repairs of the ships can be carried out. This is also known as graving dock. It is a rectangular lined excavation located in the foreshore of the harbor. It has an entrance which may be opened or closed by the means of gate, and there is a pumping plant to remove the water inside the dock. These have been built of stone, brick, timber, concrete and steel. Next, moving across to the floating docks. A floating dock is a hollow structure made up of steel or RCC. If a vessel is to be repaired in the dock, the floating dock is sunk to the repair depth by allowing the buoyancy chambers to be filled with water. These vessels is now received and berthed. The water is pumped out of the buoyancy chambers and the dock rises bodily, lifting the vessel along with it. See, in this figure, we are shown that there are two walls of the floating dock. These are the buoyancy chambers in which the water will be filled and whole structure will be immersed in the water. And then the ship that is to be carried out lifts up the ship by removing out the water from the walls. It may be defined as a floating vessel which can lift ship out of the water and retain it to the above water by the means of its own buoyancy. Lift dock. This is constructed platform capable of being lowered into and raised from water. Lowering and raising is achieved by the means of hydraulic power applied through the cylinders supporting the ends of the cross girders carrying the platform. In this figure, you will be shown how a ship is being lifted from the water to the above by the lift docks. Marine railways. These are the railways, or also known as slip dock, or also can be called as slip way, is an inclined railway extending from the shore well into the water off there. There is a railway track that is used to draw out the ship needing repair out of the water. Hence, the components of main docks are the cradle and the track. As you can see, the cradle and the tack that is being lifted up and the ship inside it is lifted to the ground surface for its repair and normal maintenance purpose. Moving across to the lock. A lock is a device for raising or lowering of the boats between the stretches of water. It is used to make the river more easily navigable or to allow a canal to take a reasonable direct line across the land that is not in level. Lock gates have two pairs of gates with a lock chamber in between. The gates can be closed against a sill raised 60 cm above the gate floor. In order to fill or make the lock empty, sluiceways are formed in the side walls. The lock is paved at the bottom by inverted arch flooring to resist the upward water pressure when the lock level is low. Next, we come across to the lock gates. Generally, lock gates are made up of timber or iron. They are made in pairs. Gates provided at the upper and the lower ends of the lock chamber. If smaller vessels were expected more frequently, it is customary to provide an intermediate pair of gates. Hence, there are different types of gates that can be provided: meter gates, sector gates, rolling lock gates, and lift gates. Now, meter gates. As you can see in this figure, it consists of two levees of equal size. Turn about a vertical axis in the recess in the opposite lock walls. When closed, the two levee meters support each other. Hence, these docks are known as meter docks. Moving across to the sector gates, these are either horizontally or vertically framed. High narrow gates are generally framed horizontally and the low broad gates are vertically framed. In the latter case, the gates are mounted on a vertical trunnion. Closure of the lock chamber is accomplished by the two gates mounted in opposition so that they abut when closed. Rolling lock gates. This consists of a steel frame sheeted on one side which operates on flanged wheels running on track embedded in a lock floor. In of the open position, the gate is housed in a recess in the wall. The lock chamber is closed by rolling gates on its track out of the recess. Lift gates. These are hung from the portal frame spanning the lock chamber by the means of chain or wire ropes. Projection of the top of the vessel will be hindrance for movement under the gate, its lifted position. So I hope that this chapter gives you all the information about the docks and the locks. Thank you.